morning students. In our last video, we have started our second number chapter, that is multiplication and division of integers. Okay, and we have seen our practice set number 8. It means multiplication of integers. Let's take a revision of that topic. So what is the meaning of multiplication of integers? We have know that is both the numbers are positive and we have to do the multiplication. It means our answer is also positive. Suppose one negative and another number positive is there, that time our answer is negative. Positive, negative, it means what? In our multiplication, the rules of integer, it just like that. No bigger number and smaller number we have to consider. Only we have to see. Suppose the negative number is there, that time we have to give the sign of negative to the answer. And if both the numbers are negative, it means minus 9 multiplied by minus 2. Both the numbers are negative, at that time our answer becomes positive. In this way we have seen the multiplication of integers. So today we are going to learn division of integers. If you observe, the rules of multiplication and division is same. It means first rule we have seen, plus multiplied by plus, our answer comes plus. What is the meaning of this? Positive integer multiplied by positive integer, answer is positive. Minus multiplied by plus, answer is minus. It means negative integer multiplied by positive integer, answer is negative. And next one, minus multiplied by minus, answer is plus. It means both the numbers are negative, that time our answer comes positive. Same rules we have to follow for division of integers. Okay, so I can write down these rules here. So in front of us our rules are there. That is, first rule is plus divided by plus, answer is plus. Second one, minus divided by plus, answer is minus. And third one, minus divided by minus, our answer is plus. Three rules are there in front of you, us. Plus, 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 answer is plus. Minus divided by plus, answer is minus. And minus divided by minus, answer is plus. It means we have to use these three rules for division also. In the same way, we have to do the dividation also. Now, pay attention. First example is given in front of you. That is, minus 96 divided by 16. If you observe, now which rule is there? Minus. Minus 96 is there, it means this is the negative number. And plus 16, it means this is the positive. Negative and positive, it means our rule is second. Negative divided by positive, answer comes negative. It means we know that our answer is negative. Now for few seconds, we have to remove the negative sign of that number. That is 96 divided by 60. Okay, we have to write down in the dividation form that in this way, 96 divided by 16. For some time, I have removed the sign of negative, that is minus 96, remove the sign. Okay, if you observe, these both numbers are occur in the same table. And these things we have learned in 6th standard also and in 5th standard also. These both number 96 and 16 are occurs in the which table? We know that this number is occur in the table of 16 only. In the table of 16, 16 is there, and in the table of 16, 96 is there. It means we have to divide it by 16 and 16. Numerator and denominator we have to divide by same number. Whenever we can multiply to the numerator, that time we have to multiply denominator by the same number. This rule we have learned in 5th standard only. It means numerator and denominator we have divided by the same number, because in the table of 16, 96 is there and 16 is also there. After that, you know that in the table of 16, 96 is there at the place of 6. 16 6 is 96 and 16 1 is 6. Okay, 16 ones are 16 and 16 6 are 96. It means what? In the table of 16, 96 is at the place of 6 and 16 is at the place of 1. And we know that is, whenever the denominator is 1, we cannot write down that 1. Whenever numerator is 1, that time we have to write down the 1. Denominator 1 agar aata hai, to wo aap logo ne nahi likha to bhi chalta hai. It means what? We can write down only 6. 6 is the answer. Okay, but we have to go through the question. क्वेश्चन इज वन नंबर निगेटिव अनदर नंबर पॉजिटिव. लुक एट सेकेंड रूल, निगेटिव पॉजिटिव आंसर कम्स निगेटिव, सो अवर आंसर इज माइनस सिक्स इटसेल्फ. इन दिस वे वी हैव टू सॉल्व द क्वेश्चन. सेकेंड वन इज ऑल्सो इजी. सेकेंड क्वेश्चन 98 एंड 28. वी नो दैट 98 एंड 28 अकर्स इन द टेबल ऑफ 14. सेकेंड क्वेश्चन आई हैव टेकन दैट इज 98 डिवाइडेड बाय माइनस 28. अगेन वन नंबर पॉजिटिव अनदर नंबर निगेटिव इज देयर. पॉजिटिव निगेटिव वी हैव टू डू पॉजिटिव निगेटिव और निगेटिव पॉजिटिव. द ऑर्डर इज चेंज नॉट नेसेसरी. द निगेटिव पॉजिटिव इज देयर और पॉजिटिव निगेटिव इज देयर. आंसर इज निगेटिव. ऑलवेज रिमेम्बर दिस. सो पॉजिटिव एंड निगेटिव ऑर्डर इज दिस वे. इन दिस वे इट मीन्स वी हैव टू अवर आंसर कम्स इन निगेटिव फॉर्म. सो प्लीज रिमूव द डिवाइडेशन साइन वेन एवर वी कैन सॉल्व द एग्जाम्पल. दैट इज 98 डिवाइडेड बाय 28. Okay, 98 divided by 28. These two numbers are occurs in the table of 14. 14 sevens are 98. Okay, and 14 twos are 28. It means we have to divide it by 14 by the same number. So we know that in the table of 14, 98 occurs at the place 7 and 28 occurs at the place 2. Okay. Then it means 98 divided by 14 and 28 divided by 14, answer comes 7 divided by 2. But 28 has the negative sign. It means answer comes, that is 7 divided by minus 2. But always remember, denominator have no negative sign. It transferred to numerator. That means your answer is minus 7 divided by 2. In this way we have to give the sign, that is 7 divided by minus 2. Positive and negative, our answer comes minus 7 divided by 2. Denominator have no negative sign. Always remember these things. Denominator ko negative ka sign nahi diya jata hai. Ko transfer hota hai numerator ko. That's why our answer comes minus 7 divided by 2. So in this way you have to solve the whole exercise. Same way. Go through the same way. And for this, you have to learn your tables up to 30. If you can learn the tables, or in front of you your tables are there. But it's necessary to learn the tables because in our examination, in front of us, no tables are there. So you have to learn the tables up to 30. And if you can remember the tables, it means it is easy for you to think that in which table these two numbers are occur, and you can fastly solve that question properly. Okay, now next I have to take question number second. Okay, question number second is slightly hard. But some tricks are there. I can use that tricks and we can solve the question properly. Question number second is there. Question number second and third is same. And fourth is also easy. Fourth one, you have given the fish tank. And from that fish tank, you have to make the multiplication example and divideation example. For example, you have given in front of you. So it is easy for you to solve question number four. So I can take only question number two. And with the help of that question number two, you can easily solve question number three also. So write 3 division of integer such that the fractional form each will be 24 divided by 5. It means what? We want answer 24 divided by 5. Fractional form. We have to write down 3 division. That is, our answer comes 24 divided by 5. So in this some tricks are there. So that tricks you have to use at your back page. Okay. So you have to solve these tricks your back page of your notebook and thereafter write down the example in your notebook. So whatever, which tricks are there? So if you observe, in our fifth standard we have seen the fraction, that is the fraction, it means equal fraction, equivalent fraction we have learned. Equivalent fraction means what? Suppose 2 upon 3 is there. 2 upon 3 fraction is given in front of you. What is the equivalent fraction of 2 upon 3? 4 upon 6 is equivalent. It means 2 upon 3 and 4 upon 6 value is same. How is it possible, teacher? Are the equivalent fraction. Equivalent fraction, it means the value of 4 upon 6, 6 upon 9 to 8 upon 12, the value of same, that is 2 upon 3. How is it possible? If you observe, 4 and 6 occurs in the table of 2. That is 2 2's are 4, 2 3's are 6. If we can divide, our answer is 2 upon 3. And 2 upon 3 not occurs in the single table. That's why our answer is 2 upon 3. That is equivalent to 2 upon 3. Same way, 6 and 9 occur in the table of 3. 3 2s are 6, 3 3s are 9. Again, answer is 2 upon 3. 8 and 12, 4 2s are 8, 4 3s are 12. This is also occurs in the table of 4. It means our answer is 2 upon 3, 2 upon 3, 2 upon 3, that is constant. This is called as equivalent fraction. So, in the same way, we have to go such a thing. It means we have to find out the number or find out the division of integer, 3 division of integer. 24 upon 5, we have to do these things in our back page. Huh? Okay, 24 and 5, we have to multiply by same number. Same number, do the multiplication. If you have taken 2, numerator, denominator also take the 2. 24 2s are 48 and 5 2s are 10. It means 48 upon 10, this is your first division of integer. If you take 48 upon 10, okay, just like we have solved our question number first. This thing you have to do on your back page. It means this is the simple trick. Go by answer, write down the first answer, thereafter find out the question. So, in our exercise, we have to solve in this way. Our first factor and our first division of integer, that is, first division is 48 divided by 10. And solve, 48 divided by 10 occur in the same table. In which table they are occur? In the table of 2. Okay, 48 and 10 occurs in the table of 2. In the table of 2, 48 occurs at the place of 24. That is, 2 4s are 8, 2 2s are 4 and 2 4s are 8. And in the table of 2, 10 is at the place of 5. That is, our answer is 24 upon 5. Okay, it means we want 24 upon 5. This is the fractional form of each will be 24 upon 5. In the same way, divide the number, multiply by 3, multiply by 4, multiply by 5. You get the number, that is division, and you can write down that division in this way. Suppose you can divide the number by 5. Okay, such a way. These things you have to do at your back page again and again. I have told you this is the simple trick. Huh? So divide the number 24 5s are 120 and 5 5s are 25. Okay, so you get the fractional form, that is 120 divided by 25. This is your second number, 120 divided by 25. Okay, and if you want, teacher, always we have to take positive numbers, not necessary. Answer you want positive, na? Answer positive, agar aapko aana chahiye, to aapko both number positive liye to bhi chalega, both number negative liye to bhi chalega, if you are taking both the number negative, minus 120 divided by minus 25. So, we know that how to solve, remove the subtraction sign, that is 120 divided by 25. And these two numbers occurs in the table of 5, we know that 5 2s are 10, 5 4s are 20, 5 5s are 25. It means what? Both the numbers are negative. Our answer comes positive because we know the rules. Both the numbers are negative, our answer comes positive. In same way, go by this method. And in our question number 3, you have to do same way, that is minus 5 upon 7. Minus 5 upon 7 is there, na? That time you have to do in this way. Minus 5 upon 7. Answer you want negative, it means you have to do 5 multiplied by and 7 multiplied by. You have to do the multiplication, do by 2. 5 2s are 10 and 7 2s are 14. So you want answer negative. So give one number. Give the negative sign to the one number. It means minus 10 upon 14. So your answer also comes in negative form. Okay, I hope that all of you understand it. Because if you want answer negative, that time you have to take one number negative. And if you want answer positive, that time you have to take both the number positive or otherwise both the number negative. And do these things at your back page. It means you can easily find out the fraction, 3 division forms of integer. In this way, this is the first form, this is the second form. If you multiply by, I have multiplied by 2, multiplied by 5 at the back page. And then after divide by same number, divide by 2 and divide by 5. So you can get your answer properly. Okay, I hope that you can solve your practice set number 9. Question number 4 is also easy. Look at that fish tank and find out the multiplication and division examples. Okay, so in this way we have completed our chapter number 2, that is multiplication and division of integer. In our next video we have seen our chapter number 3, that is HCF and LCM. So solve the exercise and send me the photos. Okay, bye.